Hi, everybody. Welcome to Enoch and Barb, the ongoing podcast where we say whatever and we keep it PG. We keep it clean. Now, what exactly do you think we should talk about today? What do you think we should talk about? And it has to be current. Nothing stupid, nothing silly, please.
I always wondered, if someone goes on a talk show, and they pass gas.
Oh God, please.
How do they feel? Like,
did you not hear a word I just said?
What did you say? Keep it clean, it's clean. I said pass gas.
Since when is passing gas clean?
Well,
okay, look, okay, wait, before you say anything, let me specify. Okay, how can I put this?
Put it correctly.
Are you done? Let me try to get my thoughts together, please.
You should have gotten your thoughts together before you started this. I'm
okay. You know what? Hey! I'm the one who started this. Give me a minute, please. Okay. Here's the thing. When you literally, I mean, everybody farts. Everybody passes gas. We all know that. But there's a difference between being discreet about it and sanctioning it from the rooftops, like on some...
Yeah, but you can't control if gas comes out loud or if it comes out easy. Because sometimes the one that comes out loud does not have an obnoxious smell. And the ones that are soft, it can kill a nation. And so I was just wondering if it makes the person uncomfortable, because as you said, everybody passes gas, with the exception of myself, of course. And you can't control that if you're on a talk show. Some people pass gas when they're nervous.
Yeah, but the thing is, they don't sanction it on the talk show. That's the thing. They don't sanction
it. I don't care about them. I'm concerned about my knowledge of what I need to know.
You're way too curious on certain things that is kind of a... It's very...
I just want to know if they're uncomfortable.
Know that. Why do you want to know that?
Because that's not something you would know by watching the show.
Oh, they're not going to sanction that on the show. That's what I keep telling you.
Okay.
That's what
Take
I keep...
Take it easy with me. I just want to get information.
Information on what? You know what? What even is this? What even is this, man?
Well, we're having conversation.
I didn't know it was gonna start out like this. I don't know if this was a mistake or not. I don't know. Okay. So yeah, like, I don't
want to talk about something else.
But in all seriousness though, like, I don't understand why people are like so finicky about like when people like pass gas, like. Let me be specific, like, some, not all, but there's some women that don't like it when their significant other farts in front of them, and it's like, they're completely distraught.
I agree with
them. It's like, no, like, a person can't control their own gas.
I know that, but that does not mean that we want to hear it. I mean, who am I? I don't have a significant other, but I'm just saying. No, when men pass gas, it's like you're hearing a bulldozer coming from a distance. We are more dignified when we pass gas. I'm just being mean, but I choose to be mean about this, and no one can stop me from being mean about this. Okay. Men pass gas worse than women, and I know that I'm being mean, and I'm enjoying being mean about this.
You're gonna start a
a fire,
You're literally
fire.
Oh God, you're gonna start something bad. I don't know if I'm ready to post this yet, cause
it's a gas fire. Wow, that's the worst fire.
No, but like.
But look at the significance of it. You literally smell gas, and then you smell this gas. Both gas have a smell. So. Are you learning anything from all of this knowledge?
No, but here's the thing. Here's where the no, but hear this. Some people are going to be a little bit butthurt when I sanction this. Nothing bad. I'm just saying, like, what if it was on the other spectrum of things? Like when a woman passes gas, because women do pass gas, as much as they hate to admit it.
You have to say some women, because I don't.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't pass gas. I'm too proper for that.
Oh my God. You're really gonna attract the wrong people, and I don't know if I'm ready for that. I don't know if I'm ready for this.
Okay, let's have another topic.
This ain't it, Chief. Yeah, because this ain't it, Chief.
Here ends the tragedy.
No, but here's the thing. Before we go any further, let me just sanction. Let me finish this. If it were the other way around, and a woman literally is passing gas, you honestly think like an actual man is going to complain about that? So why are y'all?
He's gonna be laughing.
That's what I'm saying. He's not gonna complain about it. He's just gonna laugh it off. Like, why do y'all gotta complain about that?
Don't say y'all. I don't have a man in my life. Leave me out of the nonsense.
No, I'm speaking specifically to those who think men farting is a big issue, and it's not. You pass gas, ladies. You don't see us sanctioning that. Like,
I'm your mom, and you live in the same house with me, and not once have you ever heard me pass gas.
Just to clarify, she is joking. She is joking about that. She is joking about that, and that's it. I'm not going to say anymore. You figure it out for yourselves.
And topic number two.
Okay. What do you want to talk about?
You started, because my topic was quite exciting. You start one for yourself, and I will contribute to the conversation.
Okay, let me see.
Because I'm very brilliant, you know.
Okay.
You heard, I'm very brilliant.
Yeah, I'm not paying you no mind, because the modesty
What's
plane
that?
Is not very it's not there for you right now. So let's just
modesty.
Okay, we're let's find another topic, please, because this is getting out of hand. Okay.
Oops! It fell on the ground. Out of hand. Get it? I'm telling you.
Good God. Why didn't I see that coming? Why did I not see that?
I told you. Mine's real.
Let me tell you something about my mom's jokes. Let me tell you this. You say a specific phrase, and she'll find a way to make it, like, literal. Like, a literal thing. She'll make a joke out of a phrase and make it literal. Like, that's her method of comedy. And we're talking, I'm literally living with this woman almost 25 years.
I thought you would have said 25, because I it is appalling. You don't know what year you were born?
Oh my God, don't.
You were about to say 25, it's not 25 years.
I said almost! I said almost. Wait. I said almost.
You're talking about my weight.
Relax.
Now?
Relax.
You're talking about my weight now. That's nice.
Oh my God. What is this podcast, dude? Like, what the heck? Oh my God. What is this podcast?
The
man?
One that said weight. You don't speak about your mom's weight. That's not
the weight I was saying.
Oh, sorry, I didn't know.
Like I said, takes the specific words, makes it into a literal joke. Like, I don't even know how to explain it right,
You'll
because.
have to end it because it's going to be too long, and then we do part two because it's already too long. All my
What was
brilliance took up all the time.
you told me to think of a topic, and then just when I'm trying to think of one, you say something that distracts me.
Yeah, because we can't leave the thing running. We have to use up the space. So I decided to educate you on gas.
You There's okay, you know what? I'm done. I need to relax because I was not expecting this in the podcast. We went from talking about gas to something else. I don't know what. God help me. We're gonna end this
Bye.
we're gonna end this podcast right now.
Bye.
Can I do the outro, please?
Oh, sure.
Do not say bye when I'm doing my outro. I'm not playing with you.
Okay.
God. Okay, so yeah, we'll talk to y'all later, and yeah, follow me on all my social medias, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter, and that's pretty much it. Okay. Bye. Bye, guys. Good Lord.